Super Rugby Final 2011, the Reds and the seven-time champion Crusaders. A capacity crowd of more than 52,000 at Suncorp Stadium. And just look at the firepower in the Crusaders lineup. The tight five is the best in the business. Dan Carter, a key as well. Sonny Bill, Robbie Fruin, Richie McCaw, the captain. Todd Blackadder is the coach. And for the Reds, Scott Higginbotham, a key at six. Bo Robinson and his matchup with McCaw at seven. And the match may well rise and fall on Will Genier and Quade Cooper at 9 and 10. The captain is James Horwell. The coach is Ewan McKenzie. Your referee in his first Super Rugby final is New Zealand's Bryce Lawrence.
We are set for Super Rugby Decider 2011.
I reckon Daniel Carter will go left side. They've had a lot of chances on that side of the field. Other teams against the Reds. There he goes.
We're underway, and it's Carter kicking off. The Crusaders in their red and grey jerseys. And now John O'Lance, only his fourth appearance in Super Rugby. The 21-year-old gets the first touch. Will Genier waiting. He'll look for the box kick, and there it goes. It's high. Coming down underneath it. It was the fullback Marshall. He couldn't control it, so on the 10-metre mark, the Reds have it. Wide they go to Cooper. He fires it out to Tapawai. Tapawai, and the captain, James Horwell, is up towards halfway, right in the Queensland, where Australia shines logo. Digby Ioane. They bottle up the left winger. Now it's Holmes. He's taken by big Wyatt Crockett. Cooper, the playmaker, gives it out now to Rob Simmons.
He was taken well by George Whitelock, moved up quickly.
I think Whitelock grabbed the ball on the way down. He did.
The Reds are going to get the put in, and it's almost in front of Rod Kafer.
Look, it is, Clark, and it's unusual to see Quade Cooper passing to one of his locks. He's normally got one of his backs outside him there. That maybe the Reds are looking for something a little bit different in this game. Early days, the first moment of the match, Dan Carter tried to pin it down to Ben Tapawai. We saw two kicks, one charge down last week and one nearly charge down off a kickoff, very similar. But the atmosphere is electric. You rarely get the goosebumps sitting on the sideline, but tonight I've got them. The crowd was standing on their feet. They were cheering on the Queenslanders as they came out, and rarely do you hear this sort of noise. It's wonderful atmosphere. Both teams really looking forward to the match, obviously. Both of them going through all sorts of hardship, and it's just going to be a wonderful game. The two best teams in the final. What more can you want?
Big moment here. The first scrum of the match. The Crusaders fancy their chances. Obviously, they've been superb throughout 2011. They believe they've got what it takes to get on top of this Reds pack.
Pause. Engage.
Ioane's first man on the top of the screen.
Both front rowers. Easy their footing there. So we'll have a reset.
Clarkey, I suspect that the Reds would have worked on quick channel one ball. Saifainga will be trying to find that little channel inside Ben Daly's feet, then straight to the left of Rob Simmons, straight to Radiki Samo's feet and hands, so he can pick the ball up and shift it as quickly as they can. They won't want to get into a long scrummaging battle here. Let's see.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Genier puts it in, and it's handed out by Samo, and quickly to Cooper. Davies brings John O'Lance in, so trying to find some space on the fringes early on, the Reds. Here's Rob Simmons, 22 years of age. What a moment for the youngsters there. And it's play on, and Whitelock comes away with it.
It was a ruck, and he was offside.
Well, he got away with it, and now it's going to come back for the Crusaders. So their first touch, and a little chip kick through from the master, Carter. And it's been picked up by John O'Lance, and he swivels out of one tackle.
Well, that showed some confidence from Lance.
And here we go now with the Digby Ioane.
So far, the Reds on the back foot. The defence of the Crusaders. Turnover at the breakdown. Genier high.
Yeah, what could they do with this one, the Crusaders? And it's been stolen in mid-air by Higginbotham. Down to Genier. There's Quade Cooper.
Brilliant kick. Brilliant kick.
He's going to sit up in the 22 for Robbie Fruin.
He doesn't kick.
And Fruin is taken. Anthony Finger cleaning up the outside centre for the Crusaders. Now Crockett floats one over the top.
Marshall.
There's an obstruction.
And he got away with that one as well.
He's done well, Tom Marshall. There were numbers on the left-hand side and they took it, the Crusaders.
So they're still inside their own territory. By about 5 metres, Ellis to Carter. Now McCaw. Ellis, Carter, giving it to Crockett. Trying to find a gap.
He was taken strongly too from Ben Daly. The Reds getting their chance to set their defensive line.
Yeah, very slow coming out of there to the short side, Carter, and now it's Corey, Flynn, Robinson and Fanger. Anthony Fanger making the tackle. They continue to work the short side. Good interplay there. And Horwell has it for the Reds. Brilliantly done.
Didn't he do well, James Horwell? Got to his feet quickly.
Back it goes now to Davies and across to Cooper. And Cooper will try the kick for Lance over on the far side. Who's going to win the chase?
Oh, Ioane
off the leg, so it should be play on, and it's towed through.
Oh, just didn't sit up for Digby. Zach Guilford.
That was an occasion where the toe through wasn't the go. Guilford pops a beauty to Sonny Bill Williams.
First touch for Sonny Bill, and now out to Maitland. And Maitland from inside his 22 bangs it into touch.
Wow, what a start.
Digby should have gone to the hands there. It bounced up. It was above his knee when it collected it. He thought a toe through would be best, but in the end, it would have been the hands. Brilliant kick by Cooper.
I don't think Quade Cooper knew it was John O'Lance out wide. And Digby came straight through it. Just sat up for him.
There. Oh.
He looked up and saw Zach Guilford in front. That was just about try time as he had numbers with him as well on his left-hand shoulder.
I think Timmy had made the decision before the bounce, I'm going to kick this, and it sat up perfectly. First line out here, important that the Reds get the set piece. Right, they go to the front to James Hall and he wins it well.
And from a standing start, it's Holmes who gets it out to Cooper and he fires it out wide again. And good ball and all tackle there from...
He lost it in the tackle.
Sonny Bill Williams, so mistake from the Reds. And they'll get the put in here, the Crusaders.
I don't know what he's appealing for, Anthony Fanger. He was copped a good hit from Sonny Bill Williams.
It was a good pass from Quade Cooper, spreading the width of the game. Sonny Bill just wrapped him up. Anthony Fanger was trying to place the ball back.
It's a good surface, but it's quite slippery. There's not a lot of grass.
He had a point there. That ball did seem to go back with him to tackle, and then he scooped it back in on the ground.
Engage! Say half 1 metre, please.
Sean Maitland off his shoulder as well.
And Carter did well to drain that in, and now it's Fruin that knocks it on.
Oh, just a little bit too far in front of him, but I think because he was on the slide while the ball was in the air, if he hit a little bit straighter, he would have taken that.
I'll tell you who did well. Ben Tapawai. He drifted in defence, probably drifted a bit too far, but got to Robbie Fruin as he got the ball.
It's good, Greg. Thank you.
Next time he'll put a short runner through with Sonny Bill.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they did use him as the decoy. He was just off Dan Carter's shoulder, and Dan Carter threw the wide pass with Robbie Fruin going away, and it just drifted on him a fraction. The bench there looking on, just talking through the backline move, just talking about what they were trying to achieve there. The guys understanding it. Dan Carter probably didn't take it forward enough and then pushed it in front of Robbie Fruin.
Pause! Engage!
Might be time for Quade Cooper to play some field position. Genia, short side.
He's on his own.
And he's got the fullback to beat, so he's going to kick over the top and chase, and it's not out. Oh, and Samo came in looking to absolutely do some carnage.
I tell you what, Kieran Reid did well to cover that because Genia had him, but Reid put the foot down and got there and forced him to chip.
He chipped over Zach Guilford's head. Guilford just turned. Quick line out, Crusaders, they play on.
Ellis to Carter and McCaw. Seven survivors from 2008's victorious team for the Crusaders, including the awesome foursome.
Yep.
Carter, interesting from Dan Carter, straight down the middle of the field to Quade Cooper. McCaw also there in 2008 with Ellis.
David.
And Reid, that's the halfway mark, and he finally found his target.
Oh, what a pass.
Yeah, it's Higginbotham. And Scott has taken ball and all. Oh, sorry, around the legs, a copybook tackle from Big Owen Franks. 10-metre mark. Reds have it.
Gee, you have to fight at the breakdown against the Crusaders.
Reds used a lot of men there at that breakdown.
Daly. Now Sayer for Enger.
What a good angle he's run there.
No
over the advantage line. And Genia continues to probe, and now he gives it to Davies, and he has left it behind, stolen by the big lock, Brad Thorne. So the Crusaders have it inside their own territory, and Carter is going to give it to Sonny Bill, and he's going to straighten, and now offloads. It wasn't a great pass, but it was cleaned up by Kieran Reid, and the Reds drive over.
Counter rucking on your feet was okay by the Reds.
Tell you what, Richie McCaw might be in trouble.
No, it's going to be a Reds put in.
There was a lot of tampering with the ball in the middle of a ruck there.
That's what can happen sometimes with Sonny Bill Williams. He always looks for the offload, and sometimes you just got to take the tackle. Threw the pass out the back to no one.
Well, the Reds are aware that one person has to tackle him. Here's the last ruck. So the ball's on the ground. Clearly, it's a ruck. There's a number seven for the Crusaders with his hand on the ball.
Good pressure, though, from the Crusaders.
Centre field scrum.
Engage!
Wade Cooper would love to have a go on the right.
And Sabo had to pick it up and go on his own.
Oh, good gain.
Plays it back. Pick and go now from Saifenga, but it was a good scrum from the Crusaders. They applied some pressure on the Reds. Slow coming out of there. Pick and go, Daly. Penalty.
Yeah, Rob Simmons went ahead of the ball, clearing them out.
So calling obstruction. And Ewan McKenzie looking just a little anxious.
Right idea. You watch Simmons here in four. Ahead of the ball. Whitelock played it well.
I'll tell you what, George Whitelock and Sam Whitelock and Brad Thorne are getting through an enormous amount of work defensively.
Todd Blackadder in the centre there. You can just see his nose and head.
Yeah, he won as a player in 98, 99 and 2000. So can he now do it as a coach? Oh, it's not straight, so the Crusaders will be disappointed with that.
It was only just straight. I'd like to see that play on when the opposition don't throw any lifters up. Should be play on. You're not trying to get the ball yourself.
Yeah, no, Timmy, the laws are pretty sensible, mate. Down the middle, both teams have got to have a fair opportunity for the ball there. There is a little bit of breeze favouring the Reds. We've seen a couple of kicks go a little bit longer, the high balls, than what they were expected, blowing left to right on your screen as you look at it now. And it's not a strong breeze by any stretch, but there's just that little hint. I think Corey Flynn put that one up in the breeze. Just got the end tailed away on the edge.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Sabo again pops it up to Genia, to Cooper. Brings Ioane in. And he's taken by Frawn and quick hands, and that is over the touchline. So that's all about pressure.
Well, that's the same play that they utilised last week against the Blues, the Reds, that Rod Davies scored his second try, and Robbie Frewen read it and rushed up.
Oh, yeah, the defence was awesome there with Frewen. Didn't go too wide. Ioane got surprised, but more so than Jono Lance.
Nicky Samo just having a little bit of problems at the back of that scrum, delivering it to Will Guinea.
Well, he threw it high to Guinea. Guinea then transferred the pressure across.
Four-man line out, not straight again from the Crusaders.
Two in a row, and the very experienced Corey Flynn. It's his 101st game of Super Rugby tonight. He's won two titles in 05 and 06. Just maybe the occasion getting to him in these opening 13 or 14 minutes. The Crusaders on that occasion also had Brad Thorne in midfield, as well as Richie McCaw, showing their intentions. As we have a look at the Reds bench, you can see Guy Shepherdson there. Second from the left of your screen, he actually got a taste of what it's like to win a Super Rugby title with the Brumbies in 2004 against the Crusaders. Radiki Samo was in the team on that occasion, the run-on team. So Genia puts it in, and this time it goes to Genia. Now Davies,
no profit
that pretty well.
No profit in that behind the advantage line to a small winger.
Penalty. So it goes to the Crusaders, and Dan Carter's going to get the first opportunity to put some points on the board. Well within his range, of course. There was a hand in there.
Shot, please.
What Will Guinea was trying to do, the Crusaders at the moment are playing two fullbacks. So their blind winger, their short side winger, is a long way back in the field with their fullback. So Will Guinea is trying to get around that short side. But it was read very well for the Crusaders. Rod Davies coming around. You can see how much pressure's on Ewan McKenzie as well.
Applause from the Crusaders bench. Dan the man. Nice strike.
Oh, no.
Right down
the left-hand side of the post.
Left-hand side. He was looking pretty confident, and then all of a sudden it just drifted out to the left. So
the Reds just need to start to play some field position now, because the Crusaders' defence is in their face.
Yes, they've tried to go wide on many occasions, but to no avail. Whitelock looks on. And Quade gives it some hang time, taken by Whitelock. So good field position for the Crusaders as Ellis gives it to Maitland. He fires it over to Sonny Bill. Bit of a shimmy. And they got the pass away. And a couple of defenders on him, and he still got it away.
Well, he attracted Tapawai and also Fainga.
And now Kieran Reid got through the tackle of Southanger, but just lost his footing. Ellis, Maitland at first receiver. Here's Crockett, taken by Holmes. Quick recycle. Now Carter gives it to Thorne. And Big Brad makes it up to the 22.
Well, they've got some numbers to the left to the Crusaders.
Ellis to Sonny Bill. Short ball, Maitland.
Oh, Higginbotham, big hit.
Scott Higginbotham, great tackle. Now Corey Flynn and the Crusaders. You just sense that they're mounting something here. Good continuity.
They're getting their forward runners across the advantage line and getting quick ball.
Now it's Ellis and Sonny Bill. Inside ball, Zach Guilford. Ellis. Flynn. Came off the foot. And the Reds have it. Advantage, though. The Reds knocked it on. It came off the foot of the Crusaders.
Oh, he's trouble.
And they're going to go to the right. No, they don't. They straighten. Now it's Zach Guilford. He kicks.
What was that about? Zach Guilford. A loose moment from Zach Guilford, just kicking away the ball. Now Cooper will try to put it long, if it can come to him.
No, it's Genia. Saifanga, he's lost it forward. Well, real pressure from the Crusaders. It's pretty much relentless.
It's at the breakdown. That's where they're putting them under pressure. Sam Whitelock, Brad Thorne, Franks as well. They're coming through the breakdown and putting pressure on Genia, and that's the way you disrupt the Genia-Cooper combination.
They're making it very awkward at the back. I can't believe Zach Guilford had a go at this. He actually had men there.
Come off. To the other thing that's got to happen, Bryce Lawrence has got to get in control of the breakdown. There's feet, there's people kicking the ball. Ewan McKenzie will be watching on, bitter about it. He's getting frustrated by the breakdown. He's right. He's telling him he's offside, and there's been plenty offside.
Is that what he said?
Yeah, I don't believe
offside.
So. They're all offside, he said. And there's been a couple of instances there. I mean, he missed there was the early offside that we saw Whitelock pick up the ball in the first couple of minutes. He was a ruck form, mile offside.
But, Cave, what they do well, the Crusaders, they go in numbers. They don't go one or two, they go in threes and fours.
Yeah, and if you're the referee and you're not prepared to make a decision instantly, you find yourself watching it and all of a sudden you forget what happens, because the Crusaders take the space over the top of the ball. They really try to dominate the territory around the ball, get themselves past it, so it looks like they're all onside. They're very, very good, very skillful at it.
They're doing well, the Crusaders. They're on the front foot.
19 minutes gone in the final. Nil all the score. One missed penalty shot by Dan Carter, but what can they conjure up here?
Pause.
The passing Crusaders.
Dangerous moment for the Reds.
One-on-one opportunities.
Ellis brings Carter in. He dummies. They don't fall for it. Anthony Fanger makes the tackle, but they're over the advantage line. And now it's Brad Thorne. And Thorne went backwards. No. Yeah, backwards. Now it's Crockett. He loses it. Genia. So no advantage for the Reds.
He's still flying in after the whistle.
In the second of the scrums fed.
Oh, it's huge, a big scrum.
Crusaders.
And Sabo just had to take it from the back. And Genia gets it out now to Cooper.
Not his best.
But into touch it goes, about 30 metres out. So it's been all the Crusaders as far as possession goes in this opening quarter of the final.
This is what the Reds had to do last week against the Blues. First 15, 20 minutes, then all of a sudden the intercept from Rod Davies. You won't get that opportunity against the Crusaders.
Brad Thorne won it at the front. Now it's Ellis having a dart, taken by Zayafanga. Reed, McCaw, lays it back. Pick and go from Reed. He thought he spotted an opening. Now it's Franks. Flynn takes it to the 22.
Oh, fourth pick and go in a row.
Here's Reed. Now McCaw hands it off to Crockett.
They're working the edges, the Crusaders forwards.
They're dragging defenders in too.
Franks. McCaw just happy to have a pick and go. There's another one. Reds will have to be careful with their discipline as well, as Franks has another little dart.
Ellis, Crusaders 10th phase, and they're still going to build pressure.
Now Ellis gives it to Guilford and can't handle it. And so Genia is going to kick it downtown. Cooper and also Ioane will chase. And Marshall flirting with the touchline over on the far side.
Reds have it. Tuapua.
How good was that?
To pick up and go through the ruck was brilliant. Genia
kick over the top. And it's going to sit up nicely. And Guilford is the one that kicks it. And it's a booming kick as well.
Oh, look at this. Roll into touch. Five out.
Oh, what a kick. Zach Guilford.
Look out. It's on.
They take it quickly. And Cooper.
Oh, that had to go. He had to put that long, Quade Cooper. Now he's in trouble.
So often he's been able to work his way out of trouble.
Oh, still in the field of play as well. Play on.
That needed to go out, that ball there.
Maitland fires it across into midfield. And now Dan Carter back to Maitland, taken by Robinson. There's and the Reds dive on the loose ball.
Numbers.
Genia. John O'Lance has to cut back infield. Claimed by Carter on the 10. Fanga. Now Rob Simmons.
A little bit flat, the Reds in attack. And so draining the defence in the last 5 minutes.
And over the top it goes, and Whitelock has it, but it's been stolen by Davies. And now Todd O'Lance tried to get the quick ball to Higginbotham, and into touch it goes.
I tell you what, the Reds have had the best of that. What you could say was after 14 phases of the pick and go, they went wide, the Crusaders. The Reds, would have lifted them tremendously.
I tell you what.
Timeout.
You and McKenzie usually seem so relaxed at the centre of the field where the players run out. He's up and walking around. Crusaders reserves look on. Look at him, he's on the edge.
Have a look at this. They're going to have a quick break here. This turf only laid 2.5 weeks ago. It's lifted up. They've informed the referee. Ground staff are on.
Tries are hard to come by in this match. And as far as the season goes, the Reds have scored 49. The Crusaders 51, so not a lot in that. Conceded tries, Reds 33, Crusaders 29. Well, with wonderful stats like that, you can see why they are the two best teams in 2011, and that's why they're going toe-to-toe here at Suncorp Stadium. It's 2-2, Reds 2, Crusaders 2. Dan Carter, one-on-one with Cooper.
Higginbotham, hasn't he pulled off some big hits so far tonight?
Not straight again, third time tonight.
Oh, Corey Flynn.
He'll have the demons in his mind, Tim.
He doesn't seem too happy about that one, but it just drifted down the right-hand side.
Touch! Touch! Pause! Engage!
Samo. Well, he had Ellis all over the top of him there, and they spotted a little knock on. Well, Ellis was right over the top of Samo.
Nine rib knock on.
That's great pressure from Andrew Ellis. He's hassling Samo at the back. He knows he's going to pick it up and just flip it up to Guinea.
There's the knock forward there.
It's a little bit naive tactically. They need to think about the back line in particular, where they're going to be under pressure, because they can't afford to take Rod Davies off that right-hand blind side wing as Brad Thorne looks on. They need to have an out there for Will Guinea so he can at least pass to Rocket Rod Davies on the right-hand side and keep possession. If he keeps trying to go to the left, Andy Ellis can be in that channel there and block it like he did then, and it puts him under pressure.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Ellis. No problem for him to pick it up, and there's the kick down the middle of the park from Carter. And now Cooper. It's a bit more on that one.
Yeah, it's well over the halfway line. No chases, though. Guildford restarts quickly.
And it goes across to Reid, and Carter snatches it out of midair. And he loses it forward. Holmes, now Cooper. Yep. Over the top it goes. Robinson gives it to Tapawai. He puts it on the toe. Advantage is over, and Ellis, not a lot of angle to play with, and Cooper, rare mistake from Quade, knocks it on the 10-metre mark.
That was an awkward one to take. It was low, it was hard, and he had to move a long way forward left.
Actually, he had to get there. What about the hit from Anthony Fanga on Carter? In the middle of the field, Cooper trying to get down low.
As he's braced himself, his body tensed up, straight out.
They had time to really try and set something, but they went for the kick.
Would you believe it? 12 minutes left in this first half. Super Rugby final, still nil all.
But it's been certainly helter-skelter for the players out in the middle.
Well, there hasn't been willy-nilly kicking either. It's been running and tackling.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Ellis. 1 meter up. Overcame a knee and shoulder bruising to get on the padding tonight. Puts it in and takes it out.
Maitland,
now it goes to the air.
Maitland is a mile offside here. Like the touchy has told him. Sean Maitland, right winger.
Played on quickly, Will Guinea.
And Tapawai got away from one. Fruin did well to sort of block the inside channel. Now the big drive coming in from the Crusaders. This is what they're so good at. And it's there again on the halfway for Ellis. But well, disrupted there from Guinea. How did he do that? He was certainly flirting with danger there as well.
That was counter-rocking from Robbie Fruin.
Guinea bit of his own back, Will Guinea, pressure-wise.
Out the back door it goes to Sonny Bill. Got away from Samo. Still was able to get his hands free. Oh, Richie on there. Play on.
Looked like a knock on.
Maitland. First cousin of Quade Cooper, Sean Maitland.
Nuts.
Now Carter going onto the front foot. Marshall. Robinson trying to disrupt it there at the breakdown. Now it's Reid. Good tackle from Tapawai around the bootlaces. Ellis. Carter, now Whitelock, George Whitelock.
The Reds are just sitting on their heels a little bit.
Robinson on it.
No, Robinson. I think he's missed it. Andy Ellis is digging for it. Oh, yeah.
Flynn. Ellis. Carter. Sonny Bill. Pops it out the back door. Maitland on the 10-metre mark. Came off the legs of Samo, now Will Guinea, and he kicks to open spaces.
Where's Rod Davies? Here he comes. Robbie Fruin going back.
And Fruin's going to pick it up inside the 22. Gives it a mighty thump across field. Ioane. He's got Cooper with him. Digby will run it into the traffic. And where's the support?
Oh, it's a Dan Carter stole that one.
His penalty. Dan Carter's accidentally gone over the ball.
Have a shot, Quade.
He was in a good position, Dan Carter, as well. He went to pick it up, just lost his feet.
Time out.
Now we've got an assistant referee, Stu Dickinson, coming in from the touchline.
Clarkie, there was an incident with Bo Robinson. Was it was it Owen Franks over the top of him at a breakdown?
Advantage would be better up here. Yeah. 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 Three grey on the ground. Just a push on the head, like an elbow down onto the head.
Right. Okay, I'll deal with that.
Just a penalty.
Yep. Three, Richie.
That's all it is.
They're just kissing.
At a nighttime nuzzle.
And it's pretty much the same.
Oh.
It's about a forearm on a guy's face back there, okay? Thank you.
Held on and held on.
Not the easiest of kicks first up for him, but the crowd will tell you. That's the angle in the distance for Quade Cooper.
Oh, yeah.
It's holding its line. It's over. It's the Reds. They've been on the back foot, really, for most of this first half so far. They lead 3-0.
Well, last week, Quade Cooper, Marto, a couple of his kicks all went to the left-hand side of the post. Looked like it was starting that way and just straightened its line.
It's not often he does get it to fade left to right.
He did a lot of work at training this week. He stayed behind a couple of sessions for an hour. Carter goes left-hand side again. Jono Lance.
Lance will run it up to the 22. Got rid of Frewen.
Oh, that's a great run out of the 22.
To carry Richie McCaw for 10 metres or so. And now the kick. Kenny had just got it away. And it's gone.
Knocked back.
Backwards.
The Reds want to get some defenders up.
And Cooper raced up to try and shut it down in midfield. And Carter goes to ground. Came off the foot, no knock forward, despite the crowd roaring, and Robinson is in there trying to disrupt it.
He's going to be careful, Bo Robinson went off his feet.
Now it's Sonny Bilf. Zach Guilford in the orange boots, you can't miss them. McCaw, Reed.
They look a little bit disjointed, the Crusaders, just one-off runners, forward runners.
Numbers on the top of the screen, Reds get there to slow the ball down.
Ellis, Franks, pretty easy target from almost a standing start. Ellis, Flynn, taken by his opposite number, Saifanga. Continuity, never a problem for the Crusaders, but not really going anywhere. Now it's Reed trying to find some space out wide.
Now Carter at first receiver.
Gives it to Sonny Bill, he throws the dummy. Turns in the tackle, can't offload this time. Ellis, Carter inside, ball, Maitland up to the 22. Phase after phase, now Carter with the kick. Oh. Carter, absolutely brilliant. And he'll run it around and put it down between the sticks.
Magnificent.
Well, it's taken a bit of Dan Carter magic.
He saw no one was home, Dan Carter. Perfectly weighted kick. Not sure what Quade Cooper was doing. He let him run around underneath the post. That could be crucial.
Well, that's battle one.
It was patience, wasn't it, from the Crusaders? They just built the phases. They chipped away, one-off runners.
There's no missed tackle here. They've got the numbers to cope. But Carter goes, there's no one in behind. Off his right, bounces perfectly. Digby Ioane was relying on Cooper to make a tackle there. He didn't go at him, and then Cooper didn't chase.
Well, you've got to make those tackles, even though behind the line. Perfectly weighted kick. Right foot. And Kafe, he's such a brilliant player, Dan Carter.
Timmy, it's always his, not just his skill set, but it's his decision making that defines him. And he's a player who rarely in big matches makes the wrong decision. And again, you know, when you've got multiple phases and you're on 10 or 11 or 12 phases, whatever the number was, the defensive line's all flat. Everybody's flat. The wingers are up. So there's only one man back, and that's the fullback, Quade Cooper. When Dan Carter looked up and he saw that Cooper was on his left, was on the right side of the defending ruck. He went to his right side, the Reds' left side, and just dropped it on his right foot and sat up perfectly for him. He knew Cooper was on the left there. So he knew Cooper had a long way to travel and couldn't get there.
I can't believe Quade Cooper didn't actually make that tackle.
Leave the ground. Oh. He was A, very deep, which allowed Carter to drop it very lightly onto his foot. And then B, he didn't leave the ground.
He's still got to make the tackle to make the conversion a lot harder.
So it's 7-3. And Dan Carter bangs it into touch.
And finally, the Crusaders get some reward for all their pressure, all their time with the ball. And such a big match player, Daniel Carter.
seized the moment because the Reds were not missing tackles.
That has certainly silenced the crowd as well, which is the objective, of course, for the Crusaders tonight. And almost won against the throw, but Daly cleans up, and Ben Daly with a good strong run up inside Crusaders territory. Back it goes to Quade Cooper, and Quade's going to try something now himself, but was he tripped?
Yeah, penalty. He certainly was, Brad Thorne.
So,
I'll tell you what, he was lucky he was tripped, because it wasn't a great kick from Quade Cooper, middle of nowhere. Just before half-time, 3.5 minutes before half-time, it's important. Brad Thorne, was it?
Yeah.
Whoop. Yep, just lifted the foot off the ground.
Watch the trailing leg.
Fatu Ali'i on the bench. He's disagreeing.
I think Brad Thorne was saying he tripped over a big bit of turf.
He apologised. He knew he'd done wrong.
It's important now for the Reds, if Quade Cooper can knock this over, to, you know, just keep in the rhythm of the game. You sort of felt like the Reds really haven't had an opportunity to attack yet. They've been holding on. And then they've done well. They were leading the game until Dan Carter scored. What you know playing against the Crusaders is this. They will score points against you. There's no question about that. It's how you respond when those points are scored. Quade Cooper can knock this over, and it's 7-6, and we're a couple of minutes from half-time. You know, the Reds are right in the game still, perfectly positioned.
Cooper from the opposite side. Looks good. It's very good. Flags are up, so it is 7-6. Crusaders in front.
I'll tell you what, he stopped. His kicking style, he stopped twiddling those, wiggling those fingers before he comes in.
I'll tell you what, that's really important for the Reds, that penalty goal there, just to stay in touch. Lots been spoken about how far the Crusaders have travelled all the way to Cape Town and back to Brisbane in 2 weeks.
Back it goes to Jono Lance again. And Tapper White. He's not going to try a kick. Remember last week he had one or two charged down. So they're inside their 22, and Cooper is back. And he banks it into touch. Since the Reds beat the Crusaders in week 15, the Crusaders have won 4 on the trot, and they've only conceded 4 tries in those 4 matches. Their defence has been absolutely outstanding. Not to mention their attack, of course. So 1.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Wherever you're watching around the globe, we hope you're enjoying this one. Super Rugby Final 2011. It's great to have you with us as Carter goes high this time. And Sonny Bill tries to chase. It's going to be Davies, but Sonny Bill has it and then loses it. Oh, gee, he had George Whitelock unmarked on the inside as well. And SBW, he can't believe it.
He'd done the hard work already by going past the ball, held onto it, and then just as he was about to think of his next move, had a look and saw Saia Fahanga about to rib him.
Outside, eh?
Well,
outside.
That was superb work, wasn't it, Sonny Bill Williams? He got up in front. Dan Carter knows how important it is to keep this ball in front of his forward pack.
Interesting scrum. It's a metre out of the 22, so Cooper can't just bang it out. They might work it up through Anthony Fahanga.
Scott Higginbotham not happy.
Half-time siren sounds. Reds will need to stay switched on, unlike last week against the Blues when the siren sounded. They just sort of clocked off. And the Blues were able to score.
The last thing the Reds need here is a scrum penalty against them with their feet. They can now just toss it out and jog to the dressing rooms.
You watch Andy Ellis, the Crusaders halfback. He'll be all over Radiki Samo and Will Guinea again to try and force a mistake.
Referee Bryce Lawrence prolonging the agony.
Stay right there, thank you.
What a big touch. Moment. The Crusaders pack will give this
touch
even more.
Pause. Engage.
Genia wants it in quickly. Samo. gives it out now to Genia. He'll bang it into touch, and that is the end of the first half in the Super Rugby final. And it is the Crusaders leading the Reds by 7 points to 6. Converted try from Dan Carter. 2 penalty goals for the Reds. So still a lot of rugby to be played. And just how much petrol in the tank. Coached a team to 2 final appearances, the Waratahs. He lost on both occasions to the Crusaders. So will it be third time lucky for Mackenzie? Well, the Reds have got a lot of work to do. They're hanging in there. You sense only just. So that's still a long time to go.
Interesting to see you and Mackenzie talk about the Reds have got to hold the ball and put the Crusaders under a bit more pressure. Make them make tackles.
You get the feeling the Reds are just hanging on.
5-man line-out, James Horwell.
They have it on halfway, the Reds. First points in the second half, crucial, and again, Genia goes to the box kick, and McCaw leaps high, and almost getting the ball there was Davies, but they've got numbers out wide here as Sonny Bill looks to give it to Fruin, and Fruin! What a start to the second half. Inside ball. Oh, one of the fastest men on the paddock just couldn't control it. Maitland. And a try goes begging. Sean Maitland.
He just couldn't position himself. Robbie Fruin straight through. And Sean Maitland was going to go inside and outside.
Oh, the combo, though. Sonny Bill Williams and Robbie Fruin. Fruin is such an enormous unit. He can run at that pace, and he just waited for Maitland.
What's the angle? Sonny Bill straightens up, and then Fruin, bang, through the hole.
What a line Robbie Fruin ran. The right pass. Maitland was away.
Probably the right option there would have been just a little chip ahead, little grubber ahead. So Maitland would have won it.
Let off for the Reds and the Crusaders. Making the mess of a golden opportunity in the opening minutes of the second half.
They're certainly covering Will Genia's box kicks.
Penalty goes against the Crusaders scrum. Gets a white crop on the referee, so too low. And Cooper will find touch. Now the Reds will be hoping the crowd can lift them here.
Well, the crowd want to come into the game, there's no doubt. The Reds love a line out on this side because Cooper is able to use Ioane quite well as the blind winger.
Into the middle of the line out they go to James Horwell, down to Genia, and Tapawai straightens. McCaw makes the tackle. Now it's Ben Daly. They pile in. McCaw is right over the top of him.
It was lucky Ben Daly fell the wrong way.
Now it's James Horwell, and George Whitelock makes a tackle with Franks. McCaw goes in. Flat pass, Davies. Taken by Guildford. Now it's Ioane, went straight into Whitelock. Crowd thought he rushed up offside, but the referee says it was okay. And again, the Crusaders just looking to disrupt the breakdown as Samo gets a hand to it.
Kieran Reid's got his hands on it.
Now it's Cooper. Cooper got a ball around the outside, but Fruin was there to take it.
Rod Davies wasn't ready for it.
That was a moment. The ball was too good for Rod Davies. He gets a chance to redeem himself now.
Not a great kick on that occasion from Carter. So here's Robinson running it back to the 10-metre mark. And Genia puts it over the top and into touch. Too big.
Wasteful.
Just kicking a bit too much, Will Genia, because he's not allowed. He hasn't got any options. He needs some other options. Needs some forward runners or needs some first receiver if Quade Cooper's not there. Give him some more opportunities.
Tim, I think the other thing that's happened is there's a little bit of stress for the first time in the halfback combination of Genia and Cooper. They're feeling the pressure and it's starting to tell. Every player comes under these in big games and they're starting to feel it now. We're going to get a good glimpse of how they're going to deal with these moments.
Oh, that's been left behind. It's play on, though. And now Cooper goes wide to Tapawai and he steps through him. Tapawai got away from McCaw. No, ankle tap by Ritchie.
He responded well to get to his feet.
Genia,
ball counter rocking. Here it comes from the Crusaders.
Ritchie didn't touch the ball tonight.
Oh, and coughed up there by Daly. And so now it's Ellis and he kicks.
Oh, clever kick too.
Vantage is over and Digby is back in the 22.
Oh, he's had a look.
It's lost forward by Digby Ioane. So there's some nerves out there. And now the Crusaders pile in, but they are going to pack the scrum down.
Digby had plenty of time. He was thinking about what he was going to do before he picked up the ball.
The pressure's in the mind too, because he doesn't kick well, Digby. He was trying to work out how he's going to get out of this boxed-in situation. Does he have a look? Watch his eye line. Yes, just there.
Andy Ellis, four or five kicks to that side of the field. Just made them sit up, put the ball in behind the Reds' defence.
Touch! Pause! And go!
Ellis with the put-in. To Carter and Dan gets it to Sonny Bell. Numbers on the far side, but Brad Thorne's going to back himself and he's going to get over the line. Did he get it down?
Got to be close.
Samo's underneath.
Come up.
Well, he's confident, Brad Thorne.
Well, we're going to go up to George Ayoub, the television match official. Brad Thorne thinks he scored his 12th Super Rugby try in his final game for the Crusaders.
Well, he had to score it because he had about six players to his left-hand side. He needed to move the ball. Here we see it. He's gone over. We can't see the ball as yet. Radiki Samo was underneath.
Quade Cooper's trying to block the camera. Doing not much else.
Oh, they had so many numbers, the Crusaders.
Where's the ball?
George Whitelock as well going over.
No vision there.
Daniel Carter.
Well, Stu Dickinson, touchy on the far side, saw nothing. See a ball there?
Oh, the ball.
It's off the ground there. Well off the ground. You can see the point.
That's Radiki Samo's right arm underneath the ball by the look of it there.
Held up 5 metre scrum for mine. Jeez, did you see the angle? Anthony Fanger's left leg is under there too.
We're going to go to Bryce. Bryce, you there?
Yes, I'm here.
From the video evidence available, the players have been held up.
Okay.
5 metre scrum.
Okay.
Held up. No try.
No look of disappointment. Straight back into the business of scrumming.
They'll get another crack here. So it's still Crusaders 7. Red 6 in the final.
Now's the chance for Sonny Bill Williams and Robbie Fruin to cause some havoc in the midfield. The Reds are going to be right on their try line. You can see them pinned on the try line. Sonny Bill, Robbie Fruin, can they get their power running game going? Can they get the opportunity to carry a player across the line and score?
Also, Kate, Sean Maitland's right out on the right-hand touchline. Which usually means they're trying to spread the defensive line out for a short ball close in.
Big spaces, Timmy, between the centre pairing of Fruin and Sonny Bill Williams have really opened it up. Sean Maitland right on the touchline, really kissing that line.
Quay, the scrum gets set.
His cousin Quay Cooper's got him covered out wide.
So he's moved in 5 metres now. But this is especially for the Crusaders.
All full props higher on the crutch.
They might try a back row move, the Crusaders, because there's so much pressure on the red scrum. All the Reds back row, Samo, Robertson, Higginbotham, they've got to stay on the scrum with some weight.
Touch. Pause. And go.
Ellis. Penalty.
Points.
Well, they might keep the pressure on and go for a penalty try or a pushover, or they're going to go for the points. Okay, it's a final. We'll take the three. It's early on.
Well, the Reds have done well. Think about it. Could have been 5/7 after the Brad Thorne try.
Well, it's the pressure from the Crusaders scrum, and all this week there's been a lot of talk about where is the weakness in the Reds, if there's any. And it's scrum time. The enormous amount of pressure that's coming through on the Reds daily for Anger and Holmes. White Crockett, Corey Flynn and Owen Franks.
Here it is now, Tim. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players outside him on one. Rod Davies was the happiest man in Australia at that moment. He had a lot of thinking to do. He's pushed one to the left earlier. Not that one.
There's three. They'll take it. 10 points to 6.
Tell you what, there's no sign of jet lag in the legs of the Crusaders. They're full of running.
Superbly fit team. That's always been the basis of their supremacy.
Restart from the Reds. And Maitland did well. Not Maitland, Guildford.
Taking back.
Carter. Here's Cooper. I haven't seen any of the real Cooper magic because he hasn't been allowed to display it. There's the high kick. It came off someone's head.
Oh, that'll be spectacular viewing.
And McCaw taken. Just over the 22.
Taken high by Cooper.
The Reds pouring in. But no, the Crusaders get the numbers in the nick of time. And it's very slow coming out of there. Ellis. Box kick again, and again here. Gets it out to Cooper, and now Ioane straightens. Digby Ioane up over the 22, and straight through! Digby Ioane puts it down!
Finally, there was a kick return play. Genia, Cooper, Ioane, the combination that's been so good for them. Tom Marshall hasn't seen any Digby Ioane tapes because he loves to step up his left foot and left him for dead.
Oh, the ball from Genia. Well, Genia was in trouble. Took the high ball from Andy Ellis, and the explosive work of Digby Ioane. Andy Ellis put it up and Genia was back in the box, took his time, didn't rush this, and then the long pass. Cooper did well as well. Digby straight through, hit the hole well, got through Sonny Bill Williams, and bang! Off his left foot, straight past Tom Marshall, over under the post.
Whoa! Little celebration. He's promised a full set dance. I think that means it'll go for a while if they win the match.
Was that the fake shower dance? Cooper adds the extras.
So the conversion makes it 13 points to 10. The Reds are in front.
That came from nothing, but it was what they had to do. Cave, start running.
Yeah, it was, and it was Quay Cooper's. He knows he's got Digby. When he sees Digby right next to him, he just hits him straight away. Right option. Sonny Bill was really concerned about Quay. Quay got him on the sucker punch, said, you know, Sonny was thinking, here comes the big step from Quay. Quay, quick hands to Digby through the hole. Scores a great try.
Hold here.
Jono Lance puts it into the crowd.
Tell you what's important, Digby Ioane looks like he's may have signed for a Japanese club, but the last couple of weeks he's been having a rethink about staying in Australia. Loves playing for Queensland. His opportunity for the Wallabies later in the year in the World Cup.
Well, he's certainly to be named in the Wallabies 40-man squad tomorrow.
Oh, Simmons!
Simmons came through and stole that one for the Reds. Well, it doesn't take much for the crowd to fire up. A try like that is great, and now Jono Lance. Cooper out the back, goes to the air. Not a great kick. And Cooper knocked it back. Tapawai. And Higginbotham with the chase. Digby Ioane, he's flying. Andy Ellis getting back there and he toes it into touch.
Oh, you want to see the crowd has gotten into this fixture.
Smart play from Higginbotham.
Gee, covered up a bad piece of decision making from Quade Cooper with that bomb that went nowhere. Got his arm to it and reefed it back.
He knew how important that was to get that ball back, Quade Cooper. Higginbotham, smart play, keeping the ball in field.
Oh, it was born back with Simmons and that magnificent jump.
Taken by Simmons. Ben Daly has it at the back now.
One.
Now he goes to ground. And Genia goes looking for it. Saya Fainga.
Crusaders not wasting men on that one.
Roy Robinson coming in for some work. He was staying with Quade Cooper. Tapawai halfback.
And he's got to just take it into contact. Pick and go again. Saya Fainga wriggles out of one. Over the advantage line he goes. Penalty. And that is one pick and go too many.
He's just got himself isolated through the middle.
Kieran Reid was on his feet.
And how important will that piece of defensive work from the Crusaders be in this game?
Carter finds touch, 15 from halfway.
Here it is again. There's Kieran Reid on his feet, ball on hands, still. Sayafanga trying to grab the ball. There's no doubts about that penalty. Ben Franks with the beard knows he'll be on shortly.
Knocked down, and Ellis has it.
The spring in the step of the Reds now. After the try from Digby Ioane.
And Richie McCaw, shocking pass. Went backwards, fortunately, for the captain.
Now the Crusaders under a bit of stress. The momentum of the game has changed slightly.
Ellis gets it back to Carter. Carter's going to go long, and Digby Ioane will take it. Gives it to Bo Robinson, and Bo.
Oh, Robbie Fruin.
Up towards halfway goes Robinson.
Ritz, they have lost this. It's scrappy.
Penalty.
Offside. Rob offside. Simmons, silly stuff.
It's a good run from Bo Robinson, but he needed to move it to Quade Cooper. Well, he needed to get numbers with him. He was isolated. Robbie Fruin put a good shoulder hit.
What about this moment? Dan Carter, you'd say easy, 43 metres out in front. Not a hard one for him. Yeah, why wouldn't you have given it to Quade Cooper? Here comes the hit. Watch the moment of impact. It's
Fruin. Bang!
Well, there's a couple of things there. If you're the open side flanker and you've got your 5'8 next to you, you want to give him the ball because if he runs it, then at least you can support him.
Over. 13 all in the Super Rugby final.
What a kick, Daniel Carter.
He gobbles them up, doesn't he?
He's such a patient player, Daniel Carter.
He has scored all 13 points for the Crusaders.
Here we go, time to make some changes.
Is that George Whitelock coming off?
Yeah, Matt Todd on, which means they'll have two.
Damien, what is it?
Two players at the breakdown. Actually, it's a bit of a happy hour down there, Cafe, is it?
Yes, they're all coming on. Frank's about to come on.
Also, Kant Fotualihi.
Yeah, Fotualihi about to go on as well. So some serious changes being made. Not yet, though.
No,
wait a couple more minutes.
I've been told just to hold five. There's Ellis, shake to kick, and dummy. Falls awkwardly, but it should be there for the Crusaders.
Forwards marking up against Sonny Bill Williams. No, Carter doesn't
Carter.
Give it to him. Sit down.
Now here's Cooper, and he's on his own. He looks up, and there are plenty of grey jumpers there again. Not the best kick, but Cooper tries to tap it back, and he does.
That's play on. He wasn't offside.
That's
tap back from Quade Cooper.
That might be the final moment of the field for Andy Ellis. He's done well.
And Gannier. He was outside the 22, so counter-attacking opportunity from Marshall, who now gives it to Carter. And here's Sonny Bill charging onto it, now to Fruin.
Oh, Fruin taken by Fainga.
And Lance was over the top to shut him down as well. Now it's Maitland. Such a dangerous player. Wide ball over to Whitelock. Sam Whitelock got it to McCaw. Back infield into the arms of Higginbotham.
They're starting to stretch the Reds' defence now.
Yeah, momentum again with the Crusaders, you would have to say. And Sonny Bill gives it to Carter. He puts it on the toe. And Digby Ioane. Very good from the standing start, Digby. And here's Cooper with plenty of time to his cousin, first cousin. They're up in the Waikato together. Sean Maitland to the halfway he goes. Guilford gives it to Ellis. And it's been intercepted by Rob Simmons, but no. Lost forward. They'll bring him back. Spectator try only.
Oh, but a good spectator try, Rob Simmons, you poor bugger. I didn't see it happen so quickly. He must have juggled and must have hit a Crusader and bounced back onto him.
Look at Zach Guilford saying, mate, I would have got you.
Yeah. if I knew, oh, he knew the whistle had gone.
That's a long walk back.
So what happened here?
He was onside.
What?
What's wrong?
I can't see the problem unless another camera is going to show it. It must have hit a Crusaders player because that is...
But it hits Andy Ellis in the arm, but the question is, did it go forward or backwards to Andy Ellis? I thought it went backwards. You might see it from this angle. You see it hit his arm, hits Andy Ellis, but I think it tapped back into Andy Ellis. Play on. Play on.
You've got to have control, though, Kaif. Not
if it goes backwards. You can tap the ball backwards. If it hits another player, comes back to you, it's play on.
Reds have been ripped off. Simmons has come off the field following that try.
So has Bo Robinson as well. Two changes for the Reds.
That is a huge decision by Bryce Lawrence to deny the Reds a try.
Touch. Hello. Touch.
Todd on for Whitelock.
Pause.
Got two open side loosies out there, McCaw and Todd.
Otu'ili'i on as well, halfback Ellis off.
And the Franks brothers substituting as Reed has a run and he's taken immediately by young Liam Gillen, 20. Crusaders lose the ball.
Richie McCaw putting it down.
Cooper wants it wide, but it was a little slow coming out of there. And Cooper kicking across field now for Davies. Davies will take it. And he pops it up to Higginbotham. And Scott puts it on the toe. And they run it into touch.
Oh, what about that? Cooper, the wide kick. Davies was precise with his timing. Arrived at the right time. And Higginbotham, his second magnificent grubber of the evening, that's forced a 5-metre line out.
Rod Davies, he was about 15 metres behind that. Then he clapped the hanger down, popped it up to Higginbotham. Left-footed down the field. Tom Marshall probably had a bit more time to stop, pick the ball up and come back inside.
Adam Wallace-Harrison is on there for Simmons. Who will they go to? They go to the back and tap back by Adam Wallace-Harrison. And it's sloppy play, but Cooper has to take the tackle. And Genia gives it to his captain. Now the Crusaders will have to watch their discipline. Here's Saifa'anga, taken by Franks. Genia looking both ways. Now he gives it to Ben Daly, head down, McCaw.
G drives well after the tackle, Ben Daly.
Yep, lays it back for Genia.
Cooper standing behind the ruck, telling the players where to go. Pushing them to the right-hand side now.
Okay.
Quade. Now Davies can't find a way through.
He's held up. He's held up in the tackle. They need to drive him to get him down. He's losing the ball.
And he's lost it forward.
Sonny Bill Williams, the strength.
And can't find Lihi.
Needs to send this wide.
And Cooper.
Trouble.
Yeah, they've shut him down tonight.
Crusaders have got it.
And they've lost it.
That's fortunate for the Reds.
Oh, great work from the Crusaders. Richie McCaw just put it down again. Second knock on in the last 2 minutes.
Reds are now changing hookers. James Chipper Hansen's on for Sayafanga.
But Bryce Lawrence is playing a very quick advantage for both teams. Keeping the game alive.
So Sayafanga, featured in every game in 2011. His 69th appearance in Super Rugby is over for the time being. A little over 18 minutes remaining, and we're locked up at 13 all.
Tell you what, fresh legs. You don't want to use all your reserves, because if it goes to extra time, 10 minutes each way.
And nice and quick.
Crunch! Touch! Pause! Engage!
Genia with the put in. Big shove again. Oh. It's gone around the 90. And so put into the Crusaders.
Is that the turning point of this match?
Newmark.
Brilliant pressure from the Crusaders. You see number 20 for the Reds, Liam Gill, on the left-hand side.
Well, he's not pushing on anything.
No,
Teagan-Botham not doing much.
Too soft there.
They galloped.
Got the pressure on. Crockett dominated Greg Holmes, and it was all over then.
What the Crusaders have done at scrum time, Marto, they've just held a few scrums, and then every fourth or fifth scrum, they've really put the eight-man shove on to surprise the Reds.
The gypsies of Super Rugby, the Crusaders.
Touch, pause, and go.
Fotu Ali puts it in. Reid gives it to the scrum half, and he kicks across field. It's a good deep kick. And Digby Ioane is back there, gives it to Quade Cooper. And he's going to bang it into touch.
Maybe
no.
Not quite.
Marshall, Fotu Ali'i, midfield they go. Carter and Guildford. He's got a front rower. Oh, and then he just couldn't link up with Richie McCaw.
Will Higginbotham get a hand to it? No.
Zach Guildford, he needed to look up, as he had Greg Holmes in front of him who was drifting.
Yeah, he didn't do his maths too well there, Tim.
Here it is. Stick.
He's been, for mine, he's been the best player in the Crusaders back line all year, Zach Guildford. Hasn't had a lot of chances tonight.
First throw into the line-out for Hansen, and he goes to Wallace Harrison and down to Cooper, and now Tapper White. Todd and also McCaw make the tackle. Now here's Adam Wallace Harrison. Gill. What a moment for the 19-year-old. Out there playing the Super Rugby final. Still there for the Reds. But again, plenty of pressure.
Oh,
that was touched, and it's allowed to bounce. And Fotu Ali'i got there first.
Well, there's not much defence for the Reds. Carter ignores us, though.
Over the head of Genia.
Daniel Carter just knows how important field position is.
Now Ioane, and he looks up, and he's going to take them on. Where are the forwards? They're on the 22, the Reds.
It's inside.
Genia.
John O'Lance waiting behind.
Stay red.
He's allowed to bang it into touch, and he does. A line out. About 12 from halfway, still in Reds territory.
Interesting, Marto, isn't it, when Daniel Carter had a lot of numbers to his right-hand side and chose to kick long.
Yeah, he wants to play the game down there. 13-all, penalty will come into it.
Corey Flynn, and it's sloppy, and Genia comes through. Hammered for his work, but he got the pass away to Higginbotham. Lance, Cooper's out the back. Gives it to Tapawai, he straightens. Five from halfway.
Oh, counter ruck, magnificent from the Crusaders.
No, Samo got his big mitt on it though.
Still need help.
Gill to Cooper. No, they just want to play it down the other end.
No chases.
And Marshall made no mistake with it. Now he kicks downfield, and Digby Ioane will clean it up.
That's taken back in. Can't be kicked out on the full.
You sure? Did the ref call it? Yep.
And they go high. It's going to come down around by the 10-metre mark, and it's there for the Crusaders. Lost forward by the Reds. Maitland. Advantage is over. Sonny Bill.
Oh, Liam Gould nearly had a chance.
Great ball. Thought about kicking, did he?
This game's about to open up here.
It's a scary thought because it's going to open up for the Crusaders, you'd reckon.
And Marshall, going to take on a couple of forwards. Potu Ali'i.
A lot of defenders walking for the Reds. They're not coming off the line quickly. There's a turnover.
Big hit, Adam Wallace-Harrison.
Genia.
Oh,
Genia.
There was an obstruction there.
Will Genia. Cooper's with him. He's got Cooper. Is this a magical moment coming up? Genia! Yes!
The odd couple, Cooper and Genia, embrace. Cooper went back on the inside, allowed Genia to keep going. Put the little arm out, but it became a big one. The momentum carried him over the line. Well, there were some doubts shadowing the initial pass from Will Genia, whether he ducked behind a player. Who cares? Because he's got 55 metres. Try. What a moment.
Sonny Bill Williams had Quade Cooper covered. Genia had no option but to go himself.
Quade was trying to inch around, trying to work out, how can he inform Will that he was going to go up big off his left foot?
Well, Genia was going to kick from the base in the ruck again, but he's had no success all night. He's had so much pressure.
Was there an obstruction here?
He's 65 metres out. He's straight through, no problems. Fotu Ali'i tried for the ankle tap. He's trying to pick up Quade Cooper, but Sonny Bill Williams had him covered, and he reaches out and dots it down. Sure. Will Genia, has he scored a more important try in his career?
Oh, there was one against the Crusaders 6 weeks ago, perhaps was pretty good. Will Leon McKenzie nearly a smile? No, I better go back to my laptop and do something.
Important kick for Quade Cooper, this one.
He loves this side. His fingers are wiggling.
No.
Worst kick of the night from Cooper. Didn't look like... Genia, he's run 65 metres.
Here it is again.
Straight through, straightened up. He just needed some runners with him. Cooper was the only one. He was a long way back too. Cooper, look at Sonny Bill Williams tracking Cooper. Sean Maitland needed to do a better job there on Will Genia.
18-13, still a long way to go. And Jono Lance takes it into contact, and gee, the defence is still stinging from the Crusaders.
Well, the Reds defence held on. When the cough up came, they were equal to the task.
Now, who's got the energy in the legs to get on top in the last 10 minutes?
Carter got hit.
Samo left it behind. Genia picked up here. And Jono Lance again came off. One of the Crusaders, scrum feed to the Reds.
The Reds have got to keep playing. You can't put the cue on the rack with 10 minutes to go. Daniel Carter straight to the ground.
Well, in Hansen's defence, he was already in the air, and he's hurt his wrist.
He's on his feet now.
The thing about the Crusaders, we know Dan Carter will continue to play field position and continue to pressure the Reds, ask them to make a mistake. 5 points in the game and it's not over. The Reds don't want to keep kicking the ball back. I think they're better served, keep attacking, get out of their half, sure. But when they get around halfway, Will Genia and Quade Cooper have now got to step up. Now they've got to ignite the team and try to score another one. If they can score another one, it's game over.
And Brad Thorn is off, so his career.
And here's the scrum's gone 90.
Again, the Crusaders earn the put-in. Incredible stuff from this pack.
It did go 90 just before Scott Higginbotham picked the ball up. They put enormous pressure on the Red scrum. Unsettled them in the first 25 minutes, the Crusaders.
Who's got the big play for the Crusaders? Is it Dan the Man Carter or Sonny Bill? He'll track a couple of defenders and pop it to Fruin. Will it be the speedy outside backs, the wingers? Guilford, Maitland.
What a match from Brad Thorn.
That could be the last time. It will be the last time he walks off Suncorp Stadium.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Fotu Ali'i. Good scrum by the Crusaders. They're going to go to the left. Carter gives it to Sonny Bill. And he gets the ball around the corner.
Well, he's pushed the pass. It's gone forward to Sonny Bill Williams.
Whitelock, he says it's okay. Got to a lead. And the forwards are out wide. Franks almost intercepted by Digby Ioane.
They're still working hard at the breakdown, the Crusaders, to save that one.
And they will continue to work hard. They're not going to go away.
Liam Gill.
Die wondering. Here's Carter. Sabo wraps him up, all in all.
Stolen
by the Reds. Penalty. Penalty the Reds. Scott Higginbotham.
Big
James,
moment.
James Horwill made the tackle. Scott Higginbotham was straight to the breakdown on his feet.
Cape, I think you make the point. After this line-out, the Reds will be down in the Crusaders' half. They need to hang on to the ball.
Yeah, they do. They need to, you know, Bryce Lawrence has refereed the attacking team. They've had the advantage. So if you've got the ball, the referee's going to give you the advantage. They need to now just try to get to this thing to the middle of the field, see if they can put themselves in a position to get a penalty and keep attacking. If there's an opportunity for a field goal, now's the time for Quade Cooper to slot it over and get themselves out by more than seven.
Yeah, we've got a change, an interesting one. Robbie Frewen is off.
That's unbelievable because he's a match winner.
He's the hole runner. He must be injured.
So Hansen taking his time and throwing it long.
Liam Gill.
One. And here's Fanger. Tapawai.
Through the dummy,
but he was taken by Ryan Crotty. It's out the back door. And Digby Ioane needs to run it back infield. Todd is over the top of him. Wrapping him up, ball and all. Genia. Short side, knocked down by Crotty.
The Reds would rather play on than have a scrum. Higginbotham. Well, penalty.
Penalty advantage for knocking the ball down. Yep. Ryan Crotty.
Fair enough, too. That is the laws of rugby.
Tell you what, this is wide out, right on the touchline.
Shot at goal here, Timmy. There's only one choice, mate.
Yep. You get beyond the seven, you've almost wrapped it up.
And you've got a minute to have a kick at this. You take the full minute.
Oh, look at this. What's the discussion?
Chat, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the right choice.
I think they were thinking if you put it in the corner, you keep the ball.
Oh, no.
They might have been eating up another 10 seconds as well, just having a little bit of a conference call.
What a moment. This would cap his stellar Super Rugby season. He's got the poise, he's got the maturity, he's got the ice in his veins, and listen to the crowd when this goes through.
Will it come around?
No.
Oh, no. This time he's pushed it out to the right and it hasn't gone dead, so they place it, so they'll come back to the 22. So it's still 18-13, still anybody's game.
4.5 minutes left. Plenty of time for the Crusaders to hit back.
And they're going to go short and high, and Holwell takes it brilliantly. Ioane. Genia fires it out to Tapawai. He has to step and he can't find a way through. 10-metre mark, Reds territory.
Geez, come of age the last 4 weeks, Ben Tapawai.
Daly.
Cooper wants the forwards to do some work.
He needs another 10 or so metres. So Cooper might be able to have a crack at a drop goal. Short side, no, they're going to kick over the top and that's a nothing kick. And Fotu Ali'i sends it down to the 10-metre mark and beyond. And Quade Cooper,
don't run this. Oh, trouble.
Here is big trouble.
Yeah, McCall was there. Are they charged through?
Oh, they've got it back.
Oh,
the
numbers,
Reds.
Numbers.
They need to get it. They need to give it.
Oh, Liam Gill.
And he's lost it forward.
I don't think so.
Straight down.
Straight down.
Still
not
the Crusaders
forward.
Ball.
So Maitland and Crotty. Here's McCall. Richie.
One of the touchies has made a report against a red player. Not sure what for.
Dicky Samo it'll be for a late hit.
Oh, hammer time. And now Digby Ioane needs to run out of danger.
The Reds need to start to get some numbers to the breakdown.
Scrum.
Is it going to be a penalty report?
Yeah, we've got a player, referee on the far side, Stuart Dickinson, coming in, the assistant referee.
Well, if it's a penalty against the Reds, that'll put the Crusaders right down in behind the Reds 22. Let's listen to what he's got to say.
Poor pass by the Crusaders fullback. Late hit by Red 8.
Okay, you just hold the mark there for me.
Big moment.
3 minutes.
It's going to be a penalty against Red 8 for a late hit after the pass. That's the touchdown, Robbie.
Yeah, Bryce Lawrence distancing himself from the report. Let's have a look.
Well, it was reckless. Timing was wrong.
It was lazy. That's all it was, a lazy tackle from Radiki Samo. But Quade Cooper, he had a wall of defenders in front of him. He chose to run. That's what he's been doing all year.
So a huge moment coming up here.
How far will Carter put this down? Make sure it goes out.
What a tense 2.5 minutes we've got.
52,113. Biggest ever crowd for a provincial rugby game in Australia. But more importantly now, it's been stolen by the man that gave away the penalty, Radiki Samo.
Foto Ali was in there too, ball came back.
There's chance down. Offside though. Penalty, Reds. Oh, it's all happening at Suncorp Stadium.
Goodness.
They have put so much pressure on Will Guinea at the back of the breakdown, the back of the scrum.
I'll tell you what, that's the scrum, fair enough. Three lineouts now, but apart from the four that didn't go straight from Corey Flynn earlier in the match, they've won three lineouts against the throw of the Reds. That may be the key when we wash this game up.
I'll tell you what, Quade Cooper, he made sure of his touch fine there. Only found about 15 metres.
Second half possession coming
62% for the Reds.
You've got to remember, first half was 60% of the Crusaders. The Reds need to hang on to the ball for a minute and a bit.
Higginbotham at the front.
The Reds, I think, will try to hold this now for a minute and a half. They've got to be careful they don't give it away.
He just knock it on.
Oh. Radiki Samo at the back.
Wow.
1 minute left for the Crusaders.
Here's tension. Sonny Bill Williams still out there, moving to outside centre. Crotty has replaced Fruin. One less big man.
Here's a big chance for Ben Daly on the loose head side, the left side of this scrum. Can he step it around? Can he force the Crusaders in? They'll be all, everybody will be driving with the left shoulder here to try to give Ben Daly the opportunity to wheel this scrum. Put the Crusaders towards the touchline. Can they do it?
30 seconds left now for the Crusaders. Watch out for Zach Guilford.
They go wide. Sonny Bill gets on the outside, gives it to Marshall, and now Maitland back on the inside. Big tackle. Inside the final seconds. Carter. They go to ground.
There's the siren.
Sonny Bill, Todd, Jono Lance goes up and drives over.
Oh, there's a man who's grabbed the ball on the ground.
Here's Dan Carter. Big defence in midfield from Anthony Fainga.
The Reds are scrambling.
Carter.
Could be a turnover.
Turnover, lost forward. The Queensland Reds, Super Rugby champions in 2011. Unbelievable. Will Guinea, the Australian Super Rugby Player of the Year. There's the...
He's beaten them. He's lost in two finals previously to the Crusaders. He's won in Melbourne.
And finally, some emotion from Ewan McKenzie, the coach. 18 points to 13. The underdogs, the Queensland Reds, have won in front of over 52,000 at Suncorp Stadium.
Oh, what a match. What a match.
What a finish.
What a try.
What a defensive effort.
Oh, I tell you what, the Crusaders, though, they were sensational. And spare a thought for James Slipper. Also, Benny Lucas have been part of the team all throughout the year. Don Shipley as well.
Luke Morahan. They'll be out there for the celebrations.
Finally, Ewan McKenzie gives a smile. They can't believe it, the Queensland Reds.
Can you believe it, Tim Horan? Over 100 games for Queensland. And, of course, you didn't get to taste a victory in a final in Super Rugby. Greg Martin, nearly 70 games for the Queensland Reds. How are you feeling?
Well, we've waited so long. As Queenslanders apologise. Look at Horwell thanking the crowd, pumping them up. They've played in front of the biggest crowd ever.
Oh, they will never forget this moment, the Queensland Reds.
They had worked so hard for it.
And what about the Crusaders? Let's not forget, oh, they gave wonderful. It everything. In the end, just not quite enough petrol in the tank.
I'd like to call on Mike Eagle to present the Super Rugby Trophy to your captain, James Horwell.
Thank you.